Hi, and welcome to Talking Tech. I am your host, Alejandro Hoyos, and today we are at Computex 2023. Right now, we are the G.Skill Booth. With me, it's Mark. Hey, Mark, how's it going?
Good.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you too, Alex. Welcome to the G.Skill Booth.
Awesome.
We are actually displaying lots of live demo systems, and these are featuring Intel Raptor Lake CPUs, and we're overclocking and showcasing what the limits of the overclocked memory speeds on the current platforms. And right here we have DDR5 8800 as well as DDR5 8000. Both of these are running at CL40, which is the latency that you typically find on standard DDR5 memories, which is at 4800. Right here, DDR5 8000 is actually one of our retail memory kits, and both of these support XMP technology for the overclocking as well. And both of these are running at 48 gigabytes capacity, kit capacity, with two modules of 24 gigabytes.
So I heard you also have some Sapphire Rapids platforms with some memory kits in it. Why don't we just go check it out?
Yeah, sounds good.
Okay, so now we're here with the different Intel platforms for Sapphire Rapids. I see that we have the W-3400, and then we also have the W-2400. Both of them are the overclocking SKUs. So yeah, tell us a little bit more.
So ever since Intel released these two Xeon platforms a couple of months earlier, they unlocked memory overclocking, memory RDIMM overclocking. And so we've been exploring the limits of the overclock memory on these two platforms. Right here we have DDR5 6800 with 64 gigabytes running at a low latency of CL34. So it's even lower than the 8000s that we just saw. And the RDIMM here also supports XMP. So this is a fairly high end, and this is on the quad channel version of the Xeon 2400 series XCPU. And then right here, we have the 8-channel version running at DDR5 6000, very low latency at CL30, and super high capacity at 384 gigabytes. This is 8 modules of 48 gigabytes. So this is something that's really cool, where we have huge capacity and we're able to overclock it as well. So these systems, these RDIMM systems, are pretty cool.
These systems are super impressive also, especially at the CL latencies that you have, the CL like CL30 and CL34. It is very impressive what you guys have here, and it's even better that you can, you know, they support XMP and you can overclock the systems. So Mark, thank you so much. This looks great. But I think you have also a couple of other surprises for us. So why don't we just go and check them out?
Absolutely, let's go.
Okay, Mark, so we have here a pretty interesting looking system, I think. So, and we have some LN2 tanks behind me. So tell me a little bit more about this.
Absolutely. This is a system mod we're showing off at Computex this year. With these system mods, we're trying to show that PCs don't have to be boring boxes. So with this, we're actually running at a really high CPU clock of 7,000 megahertz and memory clock of DDR5 10,000. And what we're doing is actually pumping in LN2 from the tanks behind you into the base, and then it'll evaporate inside the tank into the case, and then it'll go in to the main structure here, and then keeping it cool, we're keeping the internals at around negative 70 degrees Celsius. So as we continue to pump that through, we're gonna get some exhaust on the tops to create that eruption smoke on the very top of the pyramid. And through this really cold internals, we're able to maintain that CPU clock of 7,000 and DDR5 10,000 speed.
This is great. So I think this is a great segue for the other surprise that you have here for us today. So why don't we go and check it out?
Absolutely.
Okay, Mark, so this is the last surprise that you have in store for us. So tell us what we have here.
Behind us, we have two extreme overclocking events. One is the OC World Record stage, and that's with motherboard brands to break world records every day. And on the other side, it's the extra exciting stuff that we hold every single year. This is the seventh time we hold the OC World Cup, where we invite overclockers from around the world, and then through an online stage qualifier, the top 9 would be invited to the live stage qualifier, where we have the top 9 to compete against each other for the first 3 days. Well, today is the 4th day, and we're entering the grand finals of the competition. This is where the top 3 of those top 9 compete for the final positions, for the top 3 place positions. And the grand final, the grand finalist and the champion would get $10,000 USD in cash.
So do you know what are those tests or benchmarks that they have to do?
So the benchmarks that we had this year for the grand final is that we have two specific benchmarks chosen by G.Skill and G.Skill Master Judges. And then there are three benchmarks that each contestant, each finalist contestant, would pick for themselves. And then so there's a total of five benchmarks through just this morning and into the afternoon. And so they have to time manage very, very well in order to complete this test, these benchmarks, to get the highest score in that category. Earlier, just now, they were running 24 gigabytes for the highest DDR5 speed.
Wow.
And pretty much all finalists seem to be reaching above DDR5 10,000.
This is very, very impressive. So it's not only, I mean, it's skill, knowledge, but also time management.
Absolutely. So this is what's putting the pressure, as well as performing in front of a live crowd. We have consistent crowds and people just coming in and taking pictures throughout the day.
Yeah, so like all these different curveballs that you throw at them to see if they're really going to be able to stand and deliver that highest frequency, that highest benchmark number.
Exactly.
Mark,
exactly.
This has been an awesome tour. I love what you guys have done with the booth. Appreciate it. Can't wait to see who wins. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Hope you have a great day, man.
Thanks for coming by.
Thank you.